I think first is to assess the communication and the language of the patient and the family. If they are newcomers, how proficient they are. So if you need an interpreter, I would suggest that we get one. The second thing to assess would be the family dynamics, which is very important. So if there are more than one siblings, or you know, there is a divorce, or anything that may impact the relationships or the decision making, because decisions will have to be made. So take that into account. See who's been the primary caregiver in the family, who's the decision maker in the family. So if you can get hold of that dynamics, it makes it easier. And then have mediation available if there is a communication gap. With Muslims, what I have found is my first question, of course, always is, how long have you been here? So that gives me where on the integration cycle they are. How do they view the medical service? What have their experiences been so far? Because what happens sometimes, if they have had a bad experience in the hospital and now they have moved to palliative care, do they know, you know, have they carried that baggage into palliative care? And I've had families, you know, oh, well, this happened there and so this will happen again. No, this is not a hospital per se. This is a different environment. These are different caregivers. So that, you know, they don't have that carryover kind of anguish with them. So many variables to look at to make it a comfortable experience. Is there a trust deficit? You know, how do you cover it? How do you for them to be able to have an advocate if a conflict arises. And sometimes a conflict may arise within the family and the patient, right, on the care. So a role of an advocate becomes extremely important.